clear blue of the western sky comes Sky King. Brought to you by Nabisco, National Biscuit Company. And as we say here in the West,
partner, reach for Nabisco. Reach for Nabisco. The bright red seal on the package end means there's mighty good cookies inside, my friend.
Yep, that red Nabisco seal is on all your favorite cookies. Creamy, chocolatey Oreo cream sandwich. Rich, different Swiss cream sandwich. Yummy Big Newtons. Crispy, sweet Nabisco sugar wafers. And many, many others. So just remember, when it comes to cookies,
reach for Nabisco, Nabisco.
And now, Sky King.
You getting nervous, Jack?
Watch it, will you? For the love of heaven, let's get there in one piece. The sign said Grover, 2 miles.
That old geezer will probably pop you one right in the eye when he sees you, I bet. All right, give me it.
Give you what?
Give me it and get rid of that holster. You got rocks in the machinery? We're supposed to be traveling men. Bellhops get nosy sometimes.
There are no bellhops in this town. Where do you think you are? Still back in Phoenix? They got one hotel, one main street.
We just don't take chances.
What chances are we taking? Didn't we figure this thing out?
You better buck up, Jack. This deal with Barrett's going to take guts.
Samuel Worthington Barrett? What in the name of heaven is this?
Well, honey, I just want
to
make...
Well, look at my kitchen. I go next door for an hour and look.
Oh, Dad, we're just going to have the best cookies.
Here's your groceries, Mr. Hello, Mrs. Barrett.
Hi.
And just how many cookies are you planning to batch up?
Oh, they're really for our clubhouse, Mama. We wanted to sell some so we could buy some curtains.
And we'll clean up all this mess. Don't you worry.
Oh, you're going to look lovely at the bank Monday morning.
What?
Your best suit.
Oh, well, damp cloth, little cleaning fluid, I'll fix it up. Besides, I had to help him, honey. It takes a strong arm to beat up a big batch of batter like this.
Sam, I'm afraid your father will never grow up, Ellen.
And I'm afraid we'll never finish these cookies if you don't get out of here. Come on.
Don't worry, Mom. We'll clean it all up.
Yes, ma'am. We'll clean up right away.
I believe it when I see it.
Ow.
Afternoon.
Sky.
Martha, are the kids still here?
Indeed they are. They've got Sam in the kitchen, ruining his best suit, baking cookies.
Well, I'm afraid I'm going to have to tear them away.
Oh, and they're having so much fun.
I've got a couple of Rip Van Winkles, willing to work anywhere but home.
That's right. Say, Monday's the big day, with all your cattle coming into town.
Sam ought to have his hands full at the bank. Plenty of buyers and sellers. Say, what does Sam do with all that bank money, Martha?
You know, we keep it in a rubber sock at the bottom of the well.
That's what I thought. Hey, kids! Come on, let's go! I hope you didn't have to keep your eye on them, Martha.
Sam Barrett is 58 years old. I have to keep an eye on him.
Oh, is that so? What you been telling you about me, Scott?
Hello, Sam.
Never worked so hard in my life. Been baking cookies. Listen, those kids cleaned up that kitchen better than you and I ever could.
Oh, I'm sure.
Wish I had a million like them.
Hello?
Not if you have to buy shoes for them every 2 weeks. He manages the bank, but he forgets he doesn't own the money.
It's for you, Dad.
What?
Someone on the phone.
Me? Now, who could want me on a Saturday afternoon?
I bet we got a million cookies here to sell. Clipper, who's going to be our first customer?
It's easy to see who the first customer's going to be.
Hello?
Say, Barrett, we're a couple of traveling men. We understand you run the bank around here.
That's right.
We'd sort of like to do a little business with you today.
Well, I'm sorry, but the bank's closed, gentlemen.
If you care, I can see you on Monday.
We care, Pop. We care. And we'd just as soon not come out to the house, see?
Well, I guess you didn't understand me. I don't do any business after 12 o'clock on Saturday.
Listen, Pop. Ever hear of a man named Sinclair?
Used to be paymaster of the Cameron Railroad 20 years ago.
Oh, who is this?
We'll be at the Grover Hotel, room 204.
You shouldn't get lost.
Hello. Pop?
I'll be right down.
And you'll do as we tell you, or we're calling the police, you understand? You do as we tell you.
You're about as subtle as a drop safe, ain't you, Jack?
My name's not Jack. I've told you 1,000 times my name is not Jack.
All right, Jack. And stop looking out the window. Nothing out the window is going to do you any good, Pop.
How'd you find me? A
couple of weeks ago in the bank. I was passing through here on my way to Phoenix. They told me your name was Barrett, but I knew who you were. You haven't changed so much in 20 years.
Why didn't you go to the police when it happened, Sinclair?
When I found that the company's money was gone, and that note from Pearl saying she wasn't coming back again, that she and... that you and she had run away together, I didn't think about the police. I just wanted to go searching after you. I wasn't worried about you and Pearl stealing the company's money. Or the railroad, wondering what had happened to me. I just wanted to find my wife again.
20 years ago, Pop, the cops been looking for the paymaster of the Cameron Railroad for 20 years.
Yeah. I knew they were looking for me. 2 days after I lost your trail. If I went to the police, I was afraid they wouldn't believe my story. The money was gone, and I had run away. They mightn't have believed it if I told them my wife had stolen the money.
Oh, they might have, Pop.
I couldn't take a chance. I'd lost too much already. So I just disappeared.
When did you hear that Pearl died?
I saw a picture in an Eastern newspaper right after that hotel fire.
You got 9 lives, ain't you, Jack? You get out of everything.
20 years I've been here in Grover. I got a family. I got a wife and a child now. And you're not going to implicate them in this.
Look, Pop, just be smart. All we want's a little cooperation. Monday's going to be a busy day. There ought to be a lot of cash coming in the bank from cattle sales around here.
I told you I wasn't helping you rob the bank.
You heard what he said. We'll be coming in right after the bank closes, and you'll have the alarm turned off before we get there.
Calm down. That'll be enough of that.
I won't help you. I won't do it.
We'll give you till Sunday night to make up your mind. Remember, Sunday night.
I'll never do it. This town's given me their trust.
So is your wife and daughter. They gave you their trust, too. Sunday night, Pop. You can reach us here anytime. Day or night, we'll be right here.
Teach you by the hand of God. That which is with the Almighty will I not conceal.
Sam Barrett, what are you saying?
What?
You were just saying something.
We'll give you till Sunday night to make up your mind.
I'll never do it. This town's given me their trust.
So's your wife and daughter. They gave you their trust, too. Sunday night, Pop.
I said you were saying something.
Oh. Part of the sermon we heard this morning. Sort of stuck in my craw.
Well, for a man who falls asleep in church, you have an awful good memory.
Pretty dress.
Oh, you've seen it before.
Good night, Daddy.
Good night, Pumpkin.
Oh, Daddy, you're going to be so proud of me. I have the best graduation speech. Wrote it all myself. No help from anyone.
Yeah, it sounds wonderful, sweetheart.
Good night, Mommy.
Good night, dear. Right to sleep now.
Oh, sure. Good night.
Good night.
Martha? Do you mind if I take a drive into town? Just for the air.
Good evening, Mr. Barrett. Please come in. Your friend's been losing weight, worrying you wouldn't show. What'd I tell you? I knew he'd see it our way. Well, close the door, stupid. And lock it. You and I have a lot of things to discuss, Mr. Barrett. I wouldn't want to be interrupted.
Clipper.
Sam, we didn't think you'd mind us coming in here and taking a look at your map.
Oh, no, not at all.
Well, I'm sorry if we startled you, Mr. Barrett. We didn't mean to.
Oh, that's all right. It's just that I didn't expect to see anyone since the bank is closed.
Oh, I had no idea it was getting so late. Penny will be wondering what happened to us, Clipper.
That's right. Say, you've been around a long time, Mr. Barrett. Do you know a good horse trail up to Bald Mountain? Sky thinks you have to go clear around to Indian Creek and then up that way.
Do you know of a shorter way, Sam? I haven't been up there in a long time.
Well, I can't remember one just now. I haven't been up there in a long time either.
Something the matter?
Oh, no, nothing at all. It's just that I've got a lot of work to do, and not that I want to get rid of you or anything, but Bill Irwin's been up to Bald Mountain 100 times. He should know the best way if anyone does.
Yeah, it's an idea, Sky.
I bet she's over at the hardware store right now if you want to ask him.
Come on, Clipper. We'll see if he's there. Thanks, Sam. We'll see you later.
Wait! I'll let you out the back door. Then you can duck across the alley and go into the back of the hardware store. It'll save you walking around the block.
Hey, that's all right. What's the old saying? A step earned, a step saved?
Oh, Clipper.
I keep my car parked out there all the time. It saves me quite a few steps by doing it.
Just keep your trap shut. Let's go. Go get the old man.
Close that door. All right, now lock it.
How did you get in here? There was no alarm.
All right, everybody in the other room now, and no commotion.
Hey, what is this? That it changes our plans. The dough's in the vault. Get the suitcase filled. Well, go on. All I needed was you two.
Now that you've got us, what are you going to do about it?
Oh, don't do anything, Sky. Please. What'd you do with the other two men?
Don't worry about them. Come on, will you? What's keeping you so long?
All I can in here. I only got two hands.
See who it is. Lose them. Wait a minute.
Mr. Barrett.
You two. Get in the vault. Come on. Get in the vault.
Mr. Barrett.
What's the matter?
Pull that box out here.
Mr. Barrett.
This thing's getting out of hand.
Ah, oh, shut up.
Mr. Barrett.
All right, Pop.
I'm sorry to bother you, Mr. Barrett, but are Sky and Clipper here?
No. No, no, there's nobody here, Penny.
Oh, isn't that just like men? I told them I only had one more box of cookies to sell, and I'd meet them here. Well, may I wait for them?
No, no, I'm afraid you can't, Penny.
Something's wrong, isn't it?
No!
Come in here.
No wonder there was no alarm. The alarm wire's been cut.
They didn't take any chances.
No, they didn't, Clipper. I'm going to see if I can't set off the alarm system from in here.
Well, how can you do that?
One of the tellers got to his alarm button. The outside contact's been made. It still should be good.
What are we going to do about these two men, Sky? They're still unconscious.
Do what you can for them, Clipper.
What do we do? Can we get to the car?
No. Your car, Pop. Where is it?
In back. It's in back.
Let's get out of here. You too, sister.
Oh, can't she stay here, please?
No one will shoot us with her in the car. Move.
If only I had something to get down inside this housing with, I might be able to line those tumblers up.
How about a pencil, Sky? Would that do it?
It might.
You think it'll work, Sky?
If we're lucky.
Everybody out, please. Everybody out.
Come on, let's get out of here. Sheriff!
Holy cow, Sky, what are you and Clipper doing in there?
The bank robbers locked us in. The tellers are still in the vault. You better look after them.
Jake, see if one of them knows how to turn off that alarm.
Well, it looks like they skipped with the money. Where's Sam Barrett?
I don't know. I haven't seen him, but his car's gone from the back of the bank.
Hey, maybe they made him take his car.
They could have.
Hey, there's an out-of-state car out in front. Maybe the alarm frightened. How many with it?
Two of them.
Hey, Sky, look at here. That looks like Penny's glove. Maybe they took her with them.
If they took Sam's car, they can't be on the road more than 10 minutes.
I'll phone into Benny. Close the roads.
You know what the car looks like, but tell them to be careful. There's a girl with them.
Got it.
We're taking the Songbird. With any luck, we should spot their car. Then we can contact you by radio and you can close in.
Right.
Come on.
I thought you said there wouldn't be anyone in the bank. We waited till 5 after. You sure louse things up today, Pop.
I don't care what you do to me, but just don't harm the girl.
Leave Mr. Barrett alone.
It's all my fault, Penny. How are you going to get out of this? They'll close all the roads. There's only two out of Grover.
It's
stop the car. Take that road back there. Let's get off the highway.
They couldn't have made more than 15 miles with the start they've had.
But we don't know in which direction they went.
Take 3 minutes west. That should cover better than 20 miles, then head east. All we can do is cover the roads first.
Roger. What are we going to do, Sky?
They've got to be in this area, Clipper. If they'd have moved, we'd have spotted them.
How's that going to help?
Fly low. The first thing that moves...
They could be hiding, waiting until dark to get away. We've only got another hour.
I know, Clipper, I know.
They got us pegged, all right. They can figure out how far we've gone, but not in which direction. That's our edge. Okay, get out.
Barrett, you got us into this mess with your bungling.
Now, don't let me have any trouble with you. You got a ranch around here, ain't you?
Well, answer him. Answer him!
You said something in the car about her ranch. She and that punk kid in that fancy pants flyer. Well, how far?
About 3 miles.
They're not going to be using that ranch much today. I can see that.
What do you want our ranch for?
We're getting horses. We're riding out of this tin horn country over back trails tonight. Now start walking.
Can't I have some hot water? My feet are killing me.
They're still looking for us, but they ain't gonna find anything. What do they think they can see now?
I said, can't I have some hot water?
We ain't got time for that now. Are the horses gonna be all right you saddled?
I put them where you told me, in the barn. I took them out of the corral.
That don't answer my question.
The spotted one is the only one you could ride, he and the gray. The other ones are too wild. Mr. Barrett and I can ride anything. That man said he never rode before.
Yeah.
I'm not asking for forgiveness, Penny.
I know it. It must have been terrible to even make the decision.
I should have faced up to it. But I was trying to save my family from harm, so I put others in jeopardy. You can't run away from things, Penny. You can't run away.
Barrett, how far is it over the mountains?
About 10 miles.
That puts us in Crawford in about 3 hours. We'll catch a freight out of Crawford in the morning. All right, on your feet.
Slip around to the front. Open the door slowly and snap on the light. I'll rush them.
Who's in there? Come out with your hands up. Come in and get me.
Sky!
I've got a gun on the girl. Show in 10 seconds or I'll kill her. Who else is with you?
Nobody.
Well, well. And only you two have seen us.
And Sam Barrett.
He won't talk. It's his neck. But you know what we look like. Barrett can take us out of the county tonight alone.
I wouldn't count on that.
All right, come forward.
Nice work, Clipper.
How did you know we were here?
That spotted horse of yours that wasn't in the corral.
Oh, I prayed every minute you'd discover she was gone. They thought they were so smart making us hide the horses in the barn.
I knew nobody could catch her but you, Penny. That narrowed the place you could be pretty closely.
We didn't even call the sheriff. We were afraid to take the chance.
Well, how did you land? I didn't hear anything. You've been flying like crazy over this place ever since we got here.
We waited till dark, cut the engines, and made a dead stick landing about 100 yards off.
Oh.
Well, Sam?
You know, don't you?
I had a hunch when I saw these in your pocket at the bank. And crooks don't put ledger books back in front of cut wires with such care. It had to be you, Sam. I don't know yet why you did it, but I did hear what you told Penny a few minutes ago.
And I meant it, Sky.
Clipper, telephone the sheriff and have him come on out. Oh, I've had all the flying I want for one day.
You can never run away from anything, Sky. Nobody's ever been able to do it successfully yet. But I've lived too good a life to be licked now.
We'll do everything we can to see that you get a fair shake, Sam.
I know you will, Sky.
Sky, Clipper, and Penny may now be seen regularly on TV in a new series of adventure films. Be sure to watch for them.